الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه أجمعين اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما وعملا بفضلك يا أرحم الراحمين آمين. Respected brothers, elders and sisters, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that Allah from His mercy, His blessings, His rahmah and His barakah, that He's given us all the tawfiq to come to His house in order to pray our salat al-jum'ah. Alhamdulillah. Allah azza wa jal, the creator of the universe, He always talks about the sun, the moon, the days, the passing of the days, the passing of the night, the passing of the movement of the sun and the moon. Talks about the months and the years and the weeks. You'll find this kind of details in the Quran. For example, Allah says, فَالِقُ الْإِصْبَاحِ وَجَعَلَ اللَّيْلَ سَكَنًا وَالشَّمْسَ وَالْقَمَرَ حُسْبَانًا ذَلِكَ تَقْدِيرُ الْعَزِيزِ الْعَلِيمِ. Foundation. He is the one who causes the dawn to break. And He has made the night for rest, and the sun and the moon for reckoning, i.e. recognizing the time. This is a measure set by Allah, the All-Knowing. He also says, وَهُوَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ الشَّمْسَ ضِيَاءً وَالْقَمَرَ نُورًا وَقَدَّرَهُ مَنَازِلَ لِتَعْلَمُ عَدَدَ السِّنِينَ وَالْحِسَابِ. It is Allah the one who has made the sun a glow, and the moon a light, and determined for its stages, so that you may learn the number of years and the calculation. From this you can understand, and there are many other verses as well. For example, Allah says, يُكَوِّرُ اللَّيْلَ عَلَى النَّهَارِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala caused the night to overlap the day, and then He said, and the day to overlap the night. Why is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always mentioning about this? Okay, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to know that a time will come that the passing away of the time is very important for a human being to take control of. Okay, otherwise the time will go and they will not take any heed. Allah says that, you know the fact that you're witnessing, okay, that suddenly that there was a time when everyone had a big thing that we don't know what's happening, you know, when year 2000 will kick in. People were really worried. Some said the day of Qiyamah will take place. Some say all the database will come to an end. But well, we're in 2020 now. But I don't know if you have noticing something different that we haven't noticed before. That is that the days and the months and the passing of the year is coming very fast. It's going so fast that if we were to sit down and evaluate, do a self-evaluation, you will notice that you don't have much to write because we can't even remember. We are so used to the passing of the day and the time that we are not taking control of. Okay, we are not even taking control of. And this was not the way of our Salaf, our pious predecessors. Every second was very valuable to them. Every moment was very valuable to them. And they done a lot of work. There was a lot of barakah in their time. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always talks about the days and the nights in the Quran. The reason why, because Allah wants us to take heed. تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ فِي السَّمَاءِ بُرُوجًا وَجَعَلَ فِيهَا تَبَارَكَ الَّذِي جَعَلَ فِي السَّمَاءِ بُرُوجًا. Allah talks about the sun. And then He said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has placed path and created path in the heaven. Then Allah says that the reason why He has given us day and the night, okay, and He made the night and the day to follow in succession, khilfatan. And then Allah says, لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَكَّرْ أَوْ أَرَادَ شُكُرًا, for two things. For the one who takes heed and the one who is grateful. So the whole day and the night and the months that we see, Allah said that for two reasons Allah created. لِمَنْ أَرَادَ أَنْ يَذَكَّرْ. Who is there to take heed? Because there are a lot of people who don't believe in Allah. To them, you know, it just every single day is a day of party. Every single day is a day of disobedience. They don't care. They just want, they should say to the Prophet ﷺ, نَمُوتْ وَنَحْيَا وَمَا يُهْلِكُنَا إِلَّا الدَّهَرْ. We are here to live and enjoy life, okay? And then we're going to die. And then when time will come, and that's it. We only live once, so let's just enjoy. But not, this is not the way, this is not the Islamic teaching. The Prophet ﷺ said, خَيْرُ النَّاسِ. You know who the best person is? They said, no, Prophet Allah, tell us. He said, مَنْ طَالَ عُمُرُهُ. The one who has long life. وَحَسُنَ عَمَلُهُ. That's the most important thing. And who has, and his actions are good. Every single day he takes an account of himself. Okay, you sit down. What did I do in 2019? But I've entered 2020. How will I make my 2020 better than 2019? This is the way of the believers. It is not, you know, I know this is a really popular word. People say, what's your New Year's resolution and stuff like that. These are all just words on the lips now. But a Muslim, every single day is very important to him. That's why Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala who says, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسَبُوا. Take an account of yourself before you will be taken into account. And he used to do that. Despite the fact, he was a Khalifa. Khalifatul Muslim. And we all know, he was very busy. Every single moment was for the khidmah of the Muslims. You know, Umar, the very day he became Muslim, he stayed with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Those of you attended my durus in the evening when I used to talk about the seerah of Umar ibn Khattab, you saw every single day Umar ibn Khattab was with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. After the death of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, even the day when the Prophet passed away, he was so different. He was so emotional that he said, if anyone who says the Prophet of Allah has passed away, I will kill him. Because he couldn't come to realize that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away. When Abu Bakr read the verse, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِكَ الرُّسُلُ. Abu Bakr recited the Quran in verse that Muhammad is but a messenger. Many messengers before Muhammad passed away. So then Umar said, Wallahi, I heard this verse from the Prophet's mouth. The Prophet of Allah recited in salah and I prayed behind him, I heard him. Many times he recited, I know. But when Abu Bakr read this verse, I thought the verse was revealed just now. He opened my eyes and my bosom and my mind and I realized the Prophet of Allah passed away. Okay, but from that day, subhanAllah, Umar increased more ibadah, because now the Prophet of Allah is not here. Before we used to go to him and make a confession, we used to confess to him, I made this mistake and etc, etc. And the Prophet of Allah, now he's not here, he used to increase more ibadah, I don't want to waste my time. When Abu Bakr became the Khalifa, he stood with Abu Bakr all the way, gave him all this time, despite the fact Umar had more than 10 children. He did not neglect the children. He made them independent. He gave them time as well. But I'm saying that every single second he realized is for the khidmah of the Muslim. He stood with Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Okay? And Abu Bakr said, someone said to Abu Bakr that you're a very soft person. He said, I've got a strong person with me, Umar ibn Khattab. I've got someone else, but don't worry about it. Okay? Anyway, when Abu Bakr then passed away, Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, every single day he was planning for the Muslim Ummah. Every single day. If you read his biography, you'll notice that not one day passed where Umar did not contribute to Islam and the Muslims. Not one day passed where Umar didn't do something. He always is doing something for the Muslim. And always is doing something. He left an amazing legacy behind. But do you know what he's doing in seclusion? With something not been reported much. Allah have mercy on his son, Abdullah. Okay, he told us that you guys don't know what my father does when he goes home. Everyone, when they go home, they're like, Alhamdulillah, I've done this kind of achievement, I have this kind of money. And they everyone celebrate their achievement. Umar never celebrated. He used to go home, reprimand himself. Oh, Umar, you haven't done much today. He used to grab his beard, and he used to pull his beard, and he's punishing himself. Oh, Umar, what have you done? What have you done? Oh, Umar, a man came to you and spoke to you. Okay? And when you replied to him, he was a little disappointed. What will you do if he asks you on the day of Qiyamah that you have hurt one of the servants of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? He's Amir, he's allowed to do that. Okay? He can't make everyone happy. As a Khalifa, some people will be disappointed, some people will be upset with you. But Umar radiallahu anhu was shaking. What will I do? I am responsible. I have been given a mas'uliyah, a responsibility. What will I do when I will stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? This is the muhasabatun nafs. This is where you're taking yourself into an account. If every one of us were doing this, the world would have been a better place. Our family would be better. If every one of us take an account of ourselves, that as a father, am I fulfilling my needs? As a teacher, as an employee, or whatever profession I'm doing, am I being faithful? Am I being faithful towards my family members? Am I being honest? Am I being honest to myself? Am I being honest to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Because on the day of Qiyamah, only the truth, fullness of one will benefit him. Yeah, يَوْمَ يَنْفَعُ الصَّادِقِينَ صِدْخُهُمْ. On the day of Qiyamah, only the words of truth. If you are truthful to yourself, then that day, because you know what, the tongue will be shut. Your eyes, your body, your limbs, your hand, your feet, your legs, the parts of the body will talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-yawma nakhtimu ala afwahihim wa tukallimuna aydihim wa tashhadu arjuluhum bima kanu yaksibun. Tongues won't speak. It's not what you have trained your tongue. On that day, the truth will come out. Okay? You're probably thinking that happened, the voice will come out from the hand. Well, why did the voice come out from the tongue? Antakhan Allah, alladhi antakha kulla shay. You talk because Allah made you talk. So Allah will allow the hand to talk. The voice will come out from all of your body. The hand will say, oh Allah, this guy didn't use me properly. The legs will say, he used me to do haram. He took me to haram places. The eyes will say, I told him, remind him many times, but I used to shut my eyelids so that he doesn't see haram, but he used to open his eyes and he used to see haram. These things will talk against us. So this is why our whole body is a responsibility. That's what Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu anhu said, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Take an account of yourself before you will be taken into account. وَزِنُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ. Weigh yourself, not to see how much weight you have put on. Okay, this is the main worry nowadays, okay? I think I'm putting on weight and to go on a specific diet and etc. He's taking another meaning. He said, weigh yourself. In other words, ask yourself, what kind of good deeds have you done? Have you given your zakah for this year? Have you given your sadaqah? Have you prayed all your salah? Have you been truthful to yourself? Did you, anyone that you have offended, have you apologized to them? Do you make firm intention that inshallah from now on, that you will be faithful, you will be truthful to yourself, you will be truthful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will do something for the ummah? Because everyone comes and passes away. Sahaba, they came to the world and they passed away. Imam Shafi rahimahullah said, قَدْ مَاتَ قَوْمٌ وَمَا مَاتَتْ فَضَعِنُهُ. Imam Shafi said, so many people passed away before us. But guess what? The virtues have not passed away. He said, قَدْ مَاتَ قَوْمٌ وَمَا مَاتَتْ فَضَائِلُهُمْ وَعَاشَ قَوْمٌ وَهُمْ فِي النَّاسِ أَمْوَاتُ. And there are some people we have living with us, but they are like dead people. They're not contributing anything. Nothing. They have nothing to offer for the Muslim Ummah. They have nothing to offer for their own family members. They have nothing to offer for their own locality. We are every single ummah. You know, Ibrahim alayhi salam is one man, but Allah didn't call him one man. Allah said, Kana Ibrahim ummah. Ibrahim was one ummah. Every one of us should be like that. Okay, we have a lot of responsibility, brothers. Okay, we have to be a khayrun nas man yanfa'un nas. We have to be one of those who will benefit others. Because you know what Allah said about us? Kuntum khayra ummah. You are the best people. Out of all the nations and people that Allah has created, Allah said, the Ummah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, khayrun nas. He said, kuntum khayra ummah. Why? Ukhrijat lin nas. You have been taken out. You have been created for the benefit of mankind. Benefit of mankind. What can we do? And Allah said, this is what you're going to do. Ta'amuruna bil ma'roof. You will call towards good. Allah didn't say call the Muslim towards good. You will call the whole humanity towards good. First of all, let's start with ourselves. Call ourselves towards good. What is good? What's a'mal as-sadiha? We teach ourselves and we put it into practice. We teach our children. We teach our siblings. We teach our family members. We teach our local brothers. We teach everyone. تَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُفِ وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And you will forbid from evil. Okay? These are our duties. Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala used to say again. He said, مَنْ سَرَّهُ أَنْ يَكُونَ مِنْ هَذِهِ الْأُمَّةِ. Whoever wants to be amongst the best ummah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the best ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, فَلْيُؤَدِّ شَرْطَ اللَّهِ فِيهَا. Let him fulfill the commandment, let him fulfill that condition. What's the condition? He said, if you're not calling towards good, and if you're not stopping others from evil, then you don't deserve to be from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You don't deserve to be from the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is not just about your own ibadah. I'm going to come to the masjid, I'm going to pray my salah. No, we have to think about others. We have to think about others. You know, Umar ibn Khattab also used to say that if I were to find out a dog, he didn't say human being, a dog died without eating food, I fear on the day of Qiyamah, Allah would say, oh Umar, you were the Khalifa. Under your leadership, under your governing, a dog died without food. What did you do? He was talking about an animal. How can we allow people to die in our areas without food, without shelter? We gotta do something about that as well. This is the ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And finally, you know, Umar radiallahu ta'ala once, he was following Abu Bakr in secret. Secret, he was following him. Okay, and he saw that one, he used to go to a tent. Yeah, he went inside a tent, and then, you know, after an hour, he came out from that tent. Later on, Umar went to that tent, and he said that, you know, who was that man who came inside this temple. An old lady came up. They said, I don't know. But all I could tell you, for the past 2 years, there's a man who comes in at this time, washes all my dishes, cooks a meal for me, and etc. And he said, I will see you tomorrow. I don't even know who this man is. I must say, I know who this man is. I secretly followed him today. It was Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu. So many of our companions, they do a'mal in secret, so no one knows. When Abu Bakr died, when Umar said, لَقَدْ أَتْعَبْتَ الْخُلَفَاءَ بَعْدَكَ يَا أَبَا بَكْرٍ. He said, anyone who will become Khalifa after you, they will be very, very different. You will be a tough act to follow Allah bin al-Mu'mineen. These are the pious predecessors that we have. They're worried about themselves, and they're worried about their local people like that. So respected brothers, you know, time flies. I know Imam Shafi rahimahullah ta'ala who says that as you call it, al-waqtu kasayf, time is like a sword. If you don't utilize it, if you don't cut it, it will cut you. We have to take an account of ourselves, and inshallah ta'ala we make firm intention that my this year inshallah ta'ala, it will be better than my previous year. This is the intention that we have in terms of a'mal as-salihah, good deeds. Okay? So when death will come to us inshallah ta'ala, we meet, at least we have this intention. Niyatul mu'min khayru min amalihi. Sometimes an intention of a believer is better than his actions. Okay, so when we make innama al-a'malu bin-niyyat, if someone makes an intention and death comes to him, he will die and Allah will give him all that he has intended. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the faith to make this kind of intention, inshaAllah ta'ala. Jazakumullah khairan.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا
عنده علانية والغيب عنده شهادة فلا راد لحكمه ولا معقب لقضائه ولا رب سواه ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله خير النبي أرسله الله إلى العالم كله بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا إلى الله بإذنه وسراجا منيرا صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه صلاة وسلاما دائمين متلازمين إلى يوم الدين أما بعد فيا معاشر المسلمين نحمد الله عز وجل الذي يكور الليل على النهار ويكور النهار على الليل وسخر الشمس والقمر إن في ذلك لعبرة لأولي الأبصار يقول أنس رضي الله تعالى عنه فيما يرويه عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال لا تقوم الساعة حتى يتقارب الزمان فتكون السنة كالشهر والشهر كالجمعة وتكون الجمعة كاليوم ويكون اليوم كالساعة وتكون الساعة كالضربة بالنار أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. وفي رواية أنه قال لا تقوم الساعة حتى يتقارب الزمان ويكثر الهرج. قال يا رسول الله أيما هو؟ قال القتل القتل أو كما قال عليه الصلاة والسلام. وقد صح عن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم أنه قال خير الناس من طال عمره وحسن عمله وشر الناس من طال عمره وساء عمله. نسأل الله عز وجل أن يجعلنا وإياكم ممن يحسن أعماله في عمره ويلقى الله عز وجل وهو عنه راض. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره. بارك الله لنا ولكم القرآن العظيم ونفعني وإياكم بما فيه من الآيات والذكر الحكيم. أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله حمدا كثيرا كما امر. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله اقرارا بالربوبيه وارغاما لمن جحد به وكفر. اشهد ان لا اله الا الله السر عنده علانيه والغيب عنده شهاده. فلا راد لحكمه ولا معقب لقضائه ولا رب سواه. ونشهد ان سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وخليله خير نبي ارسله ارسله الله الى العالم كله بشيرا ونذيرا وداعيا الى الله باذنه وسراجا منيرا. صلوات الله وسلامه عليه وعلى اله وصحبه صلاه وسلاما دائمين متلازمين الى يوم الدين. اوصيكم ايها المسلمون ونفسي المقصره المذنبه بتقوى الله فاتقوا الله فيما امر وانتهوا عما نهاكم وزجر واخرجوا من قلوبكم حب الدنيا فانه اذا استولى اسر. واعلموا ان الله امركم بامر بدها فيه بنفسه وثنى بملائكه قدسي وثلث من البريه من جن وانس فقال عز من قائل عليما ولم يزل عليما ان الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا ايها الذين امنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد عبدك ورسولك صلاه وسلاما دائمين متلازمين الى يوم الدين. رضي الله عن الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين ذوي الفخر علي والفضل الجليل ابي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي وعن سائر الصحابه اجمعين. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وقنا عذاب القبر وقنا عذاب الحشر واحشرنا مع المتقين مع الإيمان. اللهم انصر المسلمين المستضعفين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها لا سيما في بورما وفي كشمير وفي الهند وفي مشارق الأرض ومغاربها وفي فلسطين وفي سوريا وأينما كانوا بلطفك وجودك وكرمك يا أرحم الراحمين. آمين يا رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين آمين يا رب العالمين. عباد الله رحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروني أذكركم واشكروا لي ولا تحرموا أخي مسلم.
Please turn in the line.